The 1400s were a magical time. Kings and queens ruled over the land, farmers tended to their crops, and people were murdered in unfair witch trials. Innsbruck was already an ancient village when Heinrich Kramer arrived, with evidence that it could have been around in the early Stone Ages. Heinrich was born in Germany and assigned to rid Innsbruck of sin by his higher-ups. A strange, sad little man of the big church, Heinrich had somewhat of an obsession with bringing witches to justice. Bible locked and loaded, he set his sights on Helena Schuber. It's not entirely clear why Heinrich chose Helena. Some say it was a sexual obsession with a married woman. Others say it was her outspoken nature that scared him. Heinrich himself claimed that Helena had used magic to murder the noble knight Georg Spies. What is clear, however, is that for Heinrich, targeting Helena was a terrible blunder. She ridiculed him, spat on him in the streets. During one of his sermons, she stood in the crowd berating him.
Fie on this man! He works with Satan!
Her campaign only served to enrage Heinrich, and his accusations against her intensified. All this attracted the attention of George Golser, the bishop. He ordered Heinrich to leave Innsbruck. However, he left with a foul taste in his mouth, and with that vile hatred, he wrote this book, The Malleus Maleficarum. The Malleus is broken into three parts. The first, mulls if witches are real. The second details how to identify a witch and what a witch will do to you. It includes such things as hallucinations of penis-stealing witches that will turn your member into a member of the Ornithine family, and many titillating stories of witches and demons doing the naughty. It reads a bit like an erotic novel that your grandma might enjoy. The final part gives advice on how to prosecute a witch. Contained are some of the most heinous torture methods ever to be used, and they were used on blameless people with no secrets to tell. But that will have to be a story for another time. Pope Innocent VIII wrote a public letter imploring witch hunters for their work. That letter heads every copy of the Malleus, lending it the Pope's approval. For nearly three centuries, this book laid on the desk of every judge, holy man, and king. Quickly, Heinrich's fairy tale became an irrefutable and immovable truth. This was the second most sold book for centuries, just under the number one spot, the Bible, and it emanates from our culture to this day. Nowhere in the number one most sold book is it mentioned that witches should be burnt, or that they steal weenies, or even that a witch is a woman. This all comes from Heinrich. And these people that were killed due to his words did not die peaceful deaths. They were hung, like the victims of Salem, by the one man who was crushed to death with stones. More famously, people accused of witchcraft were burned. Before the burnings, they were knocked out with blunt force. It was thought to be a mercy, and compared to burning to death, it was. Victims were also dunked underwater, over and over again, until they drowned. Beheaded, tomahawked, starved, strangled,
corrupted,
left to rot in a cell,
and pushed off of cliffs, assuming that if you're a witch, you would fly, but if you're innocent, you would die a noble death. Can you guess how many flew?
Heinrich died in Bohemia at the age of 75. He lived a long and wealthy life after the publishing of his celebrated works. Many of his victims died young and poor, and their names were lost to time.